everyone, and welcome back to Chemist Tea Time. I hope you all are super excited to learn more about molecular structures. So without further ado, let's jump right in. In our previous lessons, we talked about the electronic structure of some basic molecules using the Lewis dot structure. Now, I want us to think about how these molecules actually look in three dimensions. Remember that Lewis structures can give valuable information on the electronic structure of a molecule, but it fails to accurately portray the shape. The shape of a molecule can be very important for a number of reasons, including determining the polarity of a molecule. In order to visualize how molecules look, we use a model called VSEPR, or valence shell electron pair repulsion theory. The concept behind the theory is that because electrons are negatively charged, they will repel each other and stay as far away as possible, giving us the shape of our molecule. However, there are a few steps we need to follow before we can get to the whole picture. When using the VSEPR model, we consider the number of electron groups. An electron group is defined as either a bond or a lone pair. We can see the number of electron groups easily by drawing the Lewis structure. If we draw the Lewis structure for NH3, we can see that it has three single bonds and a lone pair, which means it has four electron groups. In addition, double and triple bonds only count as a single electron group. Remember, we said that the VSEPR model aims to arrange valence electrons so that they are the furthest away from each other. This means there needs to be a maximum angle between electron groups. When we have two electron groups around our central atom, the farthest they can be apart is 180 degrees. We call this a linear electron geometry because the orbitals form a straight line. When we have three electron groups, the farthest the electrons can be apart is 120 degrees, and we call this trigonal planar because it forms a triangle. With four electron groups, the farthest the orbitals can be apart is 109.5 degrees, and this forms a tetrahedral electron geometry. This is one of the flaws with Lewis structures. If you try to draw a Lewis structure with four bonds, it would look like the angles between the bonds are 90 degrees. But in reality, we need to consider three dimensions. This is why we need to use VSEPR theory when we are discussing electron and molecular geometry, because it gives us a much more accurate view of the shape of the molecule. Continuing on with five electron groups, this gives us a trigonal bipyramidal electron geometry, made up of 90 and 120 degree angles. The 90 degree angles are known as the axial positions, which are on the top and bottom, and are perpendicular to the equatorial groups, which are spaced 120 degrees apart in the trigonal plane. Finally, six electron groups gives an octahedral electron geometry, with all electron groups being 90 degrees apart. Let's try an example and look at the electron geometry of CH4, or methane. The first thing we want to do is draw the Lewis structure. I encourage you to keep practicing your Lewis structures, as many of the concepts in the next few lessons will build on that foundation. Now we can see that methane has four bonds, which means it has four electron groups. Based on this information, what do you think our electron geometry will be? If you could answer that it would have a tetrahedral geometry, you would be correct. We can also determine that the bond angle between the hydrogen-carbon-hydrogen bond is about 109.5 degrees. Well, hopefully you all enjoyed today's lesson on VSEPR and electron geometries. Next lesson, we will focus on the difference between molecular and electron geometries and the effects on lone pairs. I hope you all enjoyed today's lesson and have a wonderful day.